What's up? So I got some daily quests to do here, or some weekly, or whatever the fuck they are. And we have some decks to play. Let's play this mill deck a bit. Then I'm gonna need to play something that attacks, because one of my quests is for attacking, but. Oh, shit. I should have been attacking with my ruin crabs. Well, I'll remember it from here. So, this deck is just a good old-fashioned mill deck. That looks pretty good to me. Founding Glimpse on turn two, then we got Drown in the Lock. It's sketchy. So yeah, we're gonna Founding and then Glimpse. Sure. Take one damage. Take no damage. Alright, well, how about this? Surgical Extraction. We'll pay it. Fine. I should have paid the life, then I could have avoided him drawing a card. Decote, Surge of Salvation. Minus four spell pierces. Glimpse the Unthinkable. So we mill it up. Ooh, we got multiple enablers there. We got three of his outfitters, and two of his hammers, and a shadow sphere. That's a pretty good mill. We do have to take some damage here, though. Why wouldn't you attack with a cryptic coat? Yeah. Doesn't make too much sense. Down to 16. Eight more. Last outfitter, three out of four hammers. That's fun with Stoneforge Mystic. I like that. Alright, we take the world of damage here. That's 3, 6, 7. But he just swings for 6 because he's going to do the same thing next turn. Might be in trouble. Anowara. I think we're fucked because he has Surge of Salvation there. So this is gonna be 4, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, I count 10. Although if we hold up Drown in the Lock, we can kill one of them. Live, and then maybe glimpse Field of Ruin. I think that's our only shot. Yeah, we're dead. 2. So if he somehow doesn't attack us for lethal next turn, which he's definitely going to, I think we could mill him out. So we would crack Field of Ruin, fetch a swamp, glimpse him, mill 10, archive trap him, mill 13. But he's got to all-in attack us here. Does he do it? Yeah, he's going to. There's no way he does an all-in attack here, right? That's 7, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13. Fairdukes, so it's actually closer than it seems because we could have milled the rest of his deck next turn. Oh, I almost forgot to show the deck. Let's show the deck. Also, let's make some adjustments. I think we have one too many of these, and we might have one too many of these. And instead, let's run 2 more Frank Sanities, because it's just fucking devastating when we get that. And then, maybe, like, minus 1... Plus 1 Jace. Minus 1, plus 1 Jace. Something like that. Let's try running it like that. Alright, Paxteen. See if we can mill his deck. Yeah, we'll hold on to this. It's not... It doesn't do a lot in the early term, but it has some potential here with Archive Trap, Surgical Extraction, Jace. That's not good. Can't actually do anything to him yet. So let's just play Jace.
Emotions are distractions. Focus on the facts.
Mill three.
No secret escapes my
card. Take this, just in case we can get additional stuff out of his hand, which we couldn't. Alright. We're pretty fucked here. I'm trying to think of a way out. Gotta mill 44 cards. I mean, next turn we can drown the Clan Caller. That reduces the overall damage we're taking. 2, 4, 7, 9. Yeah, we're like super ultra dead. Do this, grab a swamp, archive trap, fatal push the Clan Caller, I think is our best line, but I don't think it's gonna be enough. It is, however, the only way we live to see another turn. Oh, no, we're dead. Fair enough. Teach me to take a slow hand. Alright. See, like, this hand would have been absolutely fine against that, you know? Like, it's just kinda... is what it is. You need the fatal push for the turn they drop the War Master so that... they don't get extra cards. Clear cat classes, whatever. Let's go ahead and pass the turn. I'm gonna play Frank Sanity next turn, ideally. Okay, sure. Perfect. Good ruin, Frank Sanity. Next turn we can mill 32 cards. Or mill 16 and kill something, which we'll probably have to do. Okay. Hold up one fatal push here. Ever more life. This is getting one. This is getting one. I Symmetry. Get our archive trap. Put it on top. Then we mill whatever he puts on top. Mill 8. He has to mill 12 more. We just have to hold on for one more turn. Next turn. No. Draw. Mill 13. Mill 21. Got him. Okay, we're about to finish our black spells, and then we'll go on to probably just Jund Suicide to finish up the attack with creatures. We got a crab. It's pretty sketchy, but we can stick that Frank Sanity. Unfortunately, we can't Fatal Push that because we have no black mana. Alright, so next turn we can have Fatal Push available. Or we can just play out Frank Sanity and say kinda like, fuck it, go all in. I think we wait. some black mana here. And let's see what he finishes up his turn with here before deciding on what to kill. In this case, we fatal push that to stop him from getting extra value. All right, I think we have to continue staying open here. Double slick shot just represents too much damage. We're gonna have to cut some of it out. Stop at combat. Big six. We are in trouble. All right. I feel like our matchup against Wizards with this mill deck is pretty impossible. Especially if we whiff lands for many turns. Yeah, we're dead. All right. We can only kill one. That's lethal. But that's okay, because our black spell should be done, and now it's time for creature attacks. Yep. Bunch of gold. Excuse me. Alright, so Jun Suicide. Alright, we can roll with this. Flood the zone with Cacophony Scamps. Sure. Hold up village rights here. I do want to use this. I want to hit land or fun spells. Land. Opponent. Two suspended cards. These has got to be whatchamacallit, Doomscar, right? That is pretty annoying.
I'll phase through anything that stands.
We can kill it, however. All right. This. This. Is this lethal? So this is 6 damage and 5 damage. So that's 11. And then this pumps to 7 and flings for 7. So we can do 11 and 7. it's actually just lethal, I think. Value one or less. Okay. That's annoying. Doomscar removes our creatures. What's our best draw? Probably
here.
Scale up? We were right about the Doomscar, by the way. Alright. We just play this. Buy this. In the turn. He pluses on the charger, we sacrifice it. To village rights.
Usually I'm better at dodging.
Scale up. So let's see here. We got a charger in the graveyard, so we're just gonna do this. Play this. Do this. That's down our Loras, that's fine. Guy, and he's got a Doomscar left. He does have this annoying land. 1/4. Gain 2/2, yep. So we're gonna play the Sellsword. In the turn. Best draw here is a slick shot. Slick shot is instant death. Okay, slick shot? Nope. Alright, well, let's just go ahead and do this. All in. I'm all in, bro. Alright, gain life, draw discard, or whatever. All in. Alright, takes 8. Or no, he takes 6. Oh, no, takes 8. This guy takes 5, gains 2. We're in trouble. No point in playing this land. Best card to draw now would probably be a scale up for sure, actually. Scale up wins the game. Scale up wins the game for us because we can overload it. We overload scale up, we have 5, 6, 4s. Wolverine creates a vampire. Can't attack anymore.
You can deal with this,
unfortunately.
We've got the edge in this fight.
Really? Well, that's not good. Alright. We do nothing. Let's Scalp will be lethal for like two more turns. Kanakuma, you don't have any creatures. Very Why are you running Kanakuma, dude? Yep, can't block it. And we're dead in three turns anyway. No, we're dead next turn, actually. So, this is our last chance. Why didn't you... Okay, sure.
Keep watch for intruders.
No creatures. Oh, it gets planeswalkers, huh? I didn't realize that. It makes a lot more sense. Come on. Gain some life. Alright, we still win if we draw the right card, which we did not. Do we have an out here? So we can... Two here. Two here. One here. And we're dead. Pretty rough at the same time, though. There was, like, a ton of outs in our deck until those last couple turns that could have easily made us win, like I said. Scale up when we had the 5-1 ones is immediate game over. Another slick shot earlier, we would have won. Maximux. Scamp claims all sword rights. I think this is fine. Play out our scamp. We have a bunch of options on how to utilize it. Alright, I swing. Fine, village rights, sacrifice, ping it. Play another scamp. No bucks. Another ornithopter, sure. We might be able to blow him out. So we could do 12 here, or I could do 8 and have the creature on the battlefield again. I think that's going to be the way. So, sacrifice this, shoot him, claim it back. Take 8, kill him on the backswing. Opponent. No blocks. Scale up is instant death. do it like this. That lets us kill both of these. Replay or scam. Now, do I trade with the Silver Fur Master? Trade with the Silver Fur Master, he just buys a... Okay. No blocks. He can ninja it all day. It means he can't get Loras back. I'd rather him get the ninja and draw a card than get Loras. Because Loras means he can start cranking out 4/4s every turn, we're not going to be able to deal with that. So, we need scale up here, desperately. Scale up just wins the game on the spot. Chill. One more turn. Great. We get a mana, we win, assuming we don't die. Yeah, the only choice is that. It might be lethal though. I think it is, actually. Because now he does 6, yeah. Fair enough. So we had him next turn if we drunk land. Kinda got mana screwed there. Although we are functional on 2 mana. Alas. But we got attacks in with creatures, and that's what's important, right? Okay. It's the first hand that looks pretty good, actually. I think we're gonna play out Scamp. Scamp represents 12 damage with scale up, nothing else. Play out the Scamp. Play out the Slick Shot. Swing with those. Fine. Alright. Oh no, I played the wrong mana! Oh no, I was supposed to play this land. Fuck. Speculative Apparition takes this land. Sure. So we play this, hit for 6, fling for 9, dealing 15. Sure. Alright, Coco. Not exactly what we wanted to see. Is it worth attacking here? I think so. Just makes a creature, right? And we can just replay it with Loris. Another Splendid Angel. Well, doesn't gain life. That's good. So we actually avoid... That's really bad. I think we still might have a chance if we can pull a scale up, but like this is gonna be really bad.
Yeah.
Alright. We're dead. But we need attacks, right? There we go. We can see it. Yeah, we might as well progress our quest, right? I think we pretty much stomp them 100% of the time in the sideboard because we have a sideboard specifically for our life gain decks, but... Bleh. Not going great today. Yep. We keep this. I'm not gonna sack it quite yet. Hey, we won one. On the draw? It's like so close. I don't think we can take it though. If I had a second mana guaranteed, I would take it. Because Claim and Slick Shot together are really strong. Okay, this is better. Sacrifice your merfolks. You want to sacrifice your merfolks? So we will probably have to stay open here. Alright, so let's do 1 year, one here, one here, and one here. No, 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 wait. Hang on. One here, one here. Thinking here. To force it. These are unblockable. So we have to push as much damage as he as we can and hope he doesn't have a yeah, he's got it. All right, we're dead. So those were unblockable anyway, so there's no reason to not push in our 1/1 token. Cause we kind of want him to trade at that point. If we get another turn we would win. Alright, this looks good. Play a Shambly Boy. Oh, we don't actually care about this. I don't think that he can Thought Seize us. I mean, Kallus Sellsword would actually be the best to take. But taking the Shambler is fine, because we can just claim it. Sacrifice it here. Good game, I guess. Get fucked, you know? Like... I do love winning against hate decks. Yeah, this is an insane hand. This hand is why we made the deck, pretty much. We play Scamp, we scale it up, we hit for 6, we fling it for 12. We do 18 damage on turn 2 and have a Slick Shot in reserve. And a Sellsword. Another scale up. A turn 3 kill. Now he's incentivized to play a creature. We play the Scamp to try and make it awkward. Because, like, now he has to kill this. Alright, sure. He doesn't get to take advantage of the mono. Show off with 2 free mana, or with 3 free mana is just lethal. Assuming we can get it to stay. One more attack. All right. I think I'm gonna pass. I wanna be able to hold up Super Stam. We don't have like a huge one shot here, so. Hopefully he fucking plays a Slick Shot, then tries to kill the Scamp. think we might just have lethal here. Yep, it's lethal. Alright, that should be our daily quest done. Go get some cards. That's kind of sick, actually. In like a sacrifice shell. The problem is you need sacrifice and ramp in the shell. I'm not sure you would be able to fit it, but like... Trample haste, X, 1X... with counters that gives you treasures when it dies, equal to the amount of mana you spent on it, basically, or minus one. Quite good. Second artifact, do flip a coin, copy the spell when you lose. It's too much. Too much conditional shit. Killing joins up. Okay, 3-mana plot, a 3-mana card. Put 1/1 counter. Pest infestation. Destroy up to X target artifacts and or enchantments. Create twice X, 1/1 black and green pest creature tokens. If that was green X, it'd be insane, but it's green XX. And I think that makes it bad. To blow up one artifact, you gotta pay 3. And you get 2 tokens. And any more than that, and you're in the late game. Yeah. Not great. Pillage the Bog. Oh, this is a good card. Yeah, this is solid. Unlicensed Hearse is decent too. New Oko. Old Oko. Well, that's cool. That's obviously a great card. I don't know if I have a playset of Okos. Hang on. Let's find out. Oko. No, I only have one. So that's actually pretty legit. Alright, let's play one more mill game, and then I gotta do some stuff around the house. Still have yet to pull a hand with more than one Mindbreak trap in it. Or Archive trap, that is. Yep. Keep that for sure. For shizzle. Play Restless Reef tapped. Next turn, play Crab. Creeb. Crab tap land. I'll take that. That's good. Alright, so let's go ahead and just field your triumph. Full of blue. Double archive trap. Mill 26 cards. I enjoyed that one. For once, we get a double archive trap somebody. For once. I need a better way to assemble a bunch of archive traps into my hand. Like, maybe you could run this in a blue, green, black shell and run a bunch of tutors and just build up a handful of archive traps with your tutors and then pop them all at once. Crab. Alright. I'm gonna crab it up. Crab. Alright, so we wanna do this. Build three. Oh, that's nice. I found your Yawgmoth. Submit this, cast this, and this. Let's just go ahead and surgical extraction your Yawgmoth here. No attacks. Glissa! You got the glizzy. Go ahead and mill four for me there, buddy. We'll push this. No attacks. How many cards left? 33 is quite a bit. Alright, do we block here? So he can blow up the enchantment if I don't block. What do I have in here? Alright. Alright, fair enough. Hang on. Control. 33. Sure, I guess. Let's go ahead and... How do we want to do this? It's actually really shit, so... Let's do this. How do we win? He's got 33 cards. Probably in a pretty bad shape here. We need land desperately, so we'll do this. Hey, bite it. did it. You did it. We can kill the Glissa. Take six. We're dead. We're dead. And the swing back is in. Well, that's not good. Can I get a fatal push one time? One time off the top? Nope. We're fucked. Oh, he doesn't have mana. Okay, well, how about Glimpse the Unthinkable? So if we gotta land, we're dead. Alright. Got a lot of questionable cards there. Like, the God's Willing, okay, I could see it. The Legion's Landing makes no sense. I mean, I guess it's a 1-1 lifelink for one. But, like, you're playing Thud Hammer Time. You're already starved for deck slots. All right, there we go. Grab. Founding. Three to fairies. cycle away. So he got three of his four Teferis. He does have four of those. Great. Let's go ahead and cast another glimpse here. Cards left, my friend. What do we want to pick up here? I think we'll chill. 13 cards. What's his way out of this? Oracles? So let's just go ahead and pay the life for this. Take the Oracle. There's one more Teferi. We already got the Oracle. I don't see him having really a way out of this. Got three No More Lies and Archmage Charm. Sure. Thin your deck more. 10 cards left. Very, I don't think, helps him.
If you show remorse, I'll hold that thought. Let's skip to the good part.
Got seven cards left. That's a heck of a draw right there. Play Jace like this. He has to counter. Okay, great. Archive trap. Got him. What's this? Okay, I don't give a shit about that. Let's play one more game. One more. One more. Nope, dude. I just ban people that try to advertise me shit, yo. Banned. See ya. Okay, so we got crab trap. Crab traps. Yep, we'll keep it. We got crab into blimps, into cacophony, into trap. Oh, that's a nice scry to the top there. I'm actually gonna go ahead and get the second crab down here. No attacks. Scry again, yo. Alright, top it is. You can get that top card with that star. But if you don't. Gonna use our archive trap here. Because we milled 12 with the crabs and another 13 with our archive trap. Alright, here you go, friend. Next turn we can mill another 18 cards. I don't think you can combo out with only with only eight. With only four cards, so. What did we hit here? Okay, Symbol's Anvil, sure. Oh, I forgot about the crabs, he's just dead. GG's. I'm calling it here for now. I got a couple things I need to do around the house. I'll come back later and put up a tutorial for my atmosphere shader stuff. Alright, so yeah. Later.